everyone! 1st of June is my birthday today. I've never actually talked to you, so I just thought I should kind of introduce myself. My name is Alyona. I'm Russian. I live in Moscow now. I was born in 1984 in this kind of family. My dad is pretty famous in Russia, especially his band Ariel was very famous in the 70s where they played Russian folk rock. So he's a lead singer and a bass player and a composer and an arranger. His music is still my favorite Russian music. I don't know, it feels like even if he wasn't my dad, I would still be inspired by that band. I love the way he sings. I love his taste in manner of singing. I love his melodies and his harmonies. I love the way he combines the instruments, the way they play together. So I think that was the base of my whole music life. When I was a kid, I was mostly listening for the kids' songs, songs from cartoons. Cinderella was my favorite Disney movie. ABBA, Whitney Houston, Ella Fitzgerald, and Marilyn Monroe. I was born in Chelyabinsk. It's the city where there are Ural Mountains, not far from them. My mom is a piano teacher, and my brother is 7 years older than me, and he is a musician, he is a great arranger, he's composing music, and he works with the TV comedy shows, and he's sometimes a great keyboard player for my band when I go perform somewhere. My first performance was when I was 4 years old, and you know where? On the anniversary of Wine Factory in Chelyabinsk. Isn't it cool? You know what? I never asked my mom why I performed there. And I was singing since then. I was singing in a kids' opera when I was in school. I was playing piano in the music school. I was very bad pupil in a regular school. Because all my time I gave to my music. I started composing songs when I was at school. My brother had Korg keyboards at that time and he was doing arrangements for some comedy shows. So when he was not at home, I tried really to do that arrangements, put the drums along with piano. I was so excited because the feeling that I can create something that was sounding in my head for the whole night, I can actually make this happen, started doing the small arrangements of my own songs, which were, first they were in Russian, because English language was one of my worst marks at school. Then I went to music college. One famous pianist was listening to me and he said, no, she's not gonna be a classical pianist. I didn't want to be an opera singer at the same time, because I already started singing jazz and tried to sing Whitney Houston songs. I was about 13, 14 years old. I was trying to repeat and duplicate them. So as far as they didn't have as many options, I chose to be a conductor of a choir. At least I would have a diploma. And then in 2 years they kicked me off for a good behavior. It's not that I was like smoking and drinking. No, I never did that actually. So I would ask them to go out and I would go to the corridor and start whistling there. I didn't think that I would harm anyone. I felt like this is just something that I need to do right now. Remember Winnie the Pooh, Disney cartoon? So they had a beaver there who was talking like this. I tried to duplicate him. I can whistle very high and in a very low volume at the same time, like what, or very, very loud also. When I was about 18 years old, we moved to Moscow, me, mom, and dad. We came to absolutely new environment, and even though my dad had much more work here, because like many people still asked him to perform, however, the whole situation, like prices are much higher because this is the capital of Russia, so that was pretty tough. I went to a music university as a vocalist, was not full-time studying. So there was one band here in Moscow, and they wanted to go to perform in Liverpool in Beatles Festival. There. Me and my dad, we were invited to join them, and I sang Here, Then, Everywhere and Rock and Roll Long Tail Sally. So that was my two first Beatles songs. And before that, I wasn't too much into rock music and even into Beatles. I was more about soft, soul, pop stuff. I remember that first time when I started shouting Rock and Roll Long Tail Sally in one of rehearsals. And that was the first time when I was actually shouting with raspiness. And I didn't expect that because I just was trying to duplicate Paul McCartney. Everybody was laughing, kind of like it was kind of a parody at first. But then I got into it, you know, I really loved that sound. I felt like a real man. So I started training that raspy voice, I started using it. I sang in that famous cavern club where the Beatles started. And the director of the festival, he came to me and he said, I'm gonna invite you next year if you're gonna sing the whole show. So we got a band with my dad and next year we went there to perform the full show in Liverpool. So I was sitting with my keyboards and I was creating my own versions of the songs because I've always loved the combination of drama and romance, or symphony and rock, or quiet and loud. That contrast made me very emotional. So this is what I was creating there in my arrangements. I did Fool on the Hill, The Long Winding Road, Helter Skelter was very harsh. We went to Liverpool 8 times overall since then. I started writing songs in English, which was a very important change for me. Once I showed my songs to one Australian producer, he was actually Russian, but he lived in Australia. And I recorded all my songs myself, all my arrangements, I prepared everything. I sent him my CD. He called me and he said, you know what, it's nice, but it's too sweet. Nobody nowadays is gonna love your music. And that was like a disaster because, you know, like I had never showed my music to anyone. I was crying like crazy for several days. I felt like I should not even write music anymore. And then I started having that kind of phobia to show my song. Like as soon as I wrote a new song, I couldn't show it to anyone. I was so scared. If you are subscribed to this channel, of course you love that music too. Those melodies, those harmonies, those powerful soft rock ballads. This is basically the music I love. Chicago was one of my favorite bands. Jason Sheff and his singing of Will You Still Love Me and Niagara Falls made me cry. And I decided to make this cover, Niagara Falls. I recorded all the instruments myself. I did the mix. I was in the United States, Florida. I did the video for that. Also myself, I edited everything myself. We didn't have Facebook or YouTube that time. We had MySpace. I found Chicago fans in MySpace and I started sending them my Niagara Falls cover. And he wrote me and it was real Jason Sheff, like the one who was singing the song. My jaw dropped when I realized that it was real Jason Sheff. He liked this song and he shared this song on his site. I also showed him my video and then his brother Darren Sheff gave me one of his songs to sing. Approximately same time I went to international vocal competition in Sochi. I was singing Whitney Houston, I Have Nothing. There were many nominations and in one of nominations I won first prize. That guy I got for the first place. And then out of all nominations they got one grand prix. And when they called my name, I couldn't even breathe. I didn't have many competitions though because it was very neurotic for me. I also got second prize in Macedonia and several more smaller competitions as well. After so many years of singing Helter Skelter in Liverpool, I was ready for Led Zeppelin. Woman, I think I'm gonna put you down. So one Led Zeppelin tribute band invited me here in Moscow to perform with them. So I said yes, and after that, this is how that all started with Led Zeppelin for me. First I loved singing Led Zeppelin and then I loved listening to them. Now Led Zeppelin is a huge, huge part of my music life. That was a fun story. When we were performing in Moscow, Chris Slade, AC/DC drummer, he just wanted to go and listen to one Led Zeppelin tribute band. So he came to our gig. He just went on stage, he wanted to play 3 songs with us. He almost blew me off of stage with that sound, with that powerful energy. And then in several months he came to Moscow and I was invited on one of the events to actually perform gig with him. Ryan Roxy was there too. He was a guitarist of Alice Cooper. That was such a great experience to play with those real rockers. Then in some time, Chick Corea, the jazz pianist, came to Moscow. I was asked to sing Night in Tunisia for him. When I sang, he came on stage and he said, this is my favorite song. I want to play it with you. Let's do it once again, but with me playing. Then I asked him to sign my keyboards. And there was my huge Korg there on stage. Then I was invited to perform in one of the rock and roll festivals there in the USA, and I was singing there in Louisville, Kentucky, on Abbey Road on the River with the guys that I met in Liverpool. I was on a TV show there in Louisville, and I had several great, great shows there, and the public there was amazing. Then later I came back to the USA and traveled there for some time. When I got back to Moscow, I started doing more videos for my YouTube channel. I started singing more, training more. This is when I met Ken Templin. I found him in YouTube. Then I sent him my cover. I was really struggling sometimes. Very often I had like swollen throat. He liked my singing. He had something to show me in terms of vocal structure, vocal health. I could sing from time to time, you know, sometimes it was easy and sometimes it was completely sick. I couldn't relax. And we met on Skype with Ken. He started helping me a lot. He showed me right breathing techniques. He showed me many, many different things, and I started working on my voice so to make myself more relaxed, so I would be able to sing like the whole day and then to sing next day. And sometimes when you have tours, you have to sing several days in a row and you have to be in shape, otherwise that's it. And I made different covers for his channel. I started practicing more and I started doing more covers for my channel, for his channel. Winger is one of my favorite bands. I did two of their covers. Them and Paul Taylor answered me back and Kip Winger answered me back, and I even met Paul Taylor here in Moscow and I showed him around. He was playing with Tom Kiefer, so Tom Kiefer was touring in 2015, so they came here in Moscow, so I was able to meet my two good friends Mike Smith and Paul Taylor. So those two covers are pretty close to my heart because Winger is a very special band for me. I love listening to that music when I'm in a special mood, or I want to get a special mood, when I want to fly away from that universe. So if you ask me what I love, I would say I'm more about a song, not about the band or about a style. When I'm making my covers, I'm learning how to mix stuff, create those combinations of sounds. So I'm thinking about making this album myself, because it's important for me to do my arrangements myself. I love creating that combination of sounds. And I know my mix, it's far from perfect because I'm not a sound engineer. I'm working on it. And at the same time, I'm working on my covers because they keep me in shape. They make running my YouTube channel. They help me to understand myself more. It's funny because I love so many different genres of music. I love jazz from Marilyn Monroe. You, my own. To Ella Fitzgerald. The moon is the same moon above you. I glow with its cool. I love pop songs. I love Michael Jackson. What about the sea? What about I love Whitney Houston. I feel so all alone. I wanna run to you. I love rock. I love Led Zeppelin. Do you remember, mama, when I could pull you? I said you had the nerve to tell me. Should I have won? I love Aerosmith. I love Guns N' Roses. Take me down to the point I see you when the boss is green and the pearls are. I love Skid Row. Many others. I'm very proud to have you as my subscribers, and I'm very thankful that you are staying with me and you are listening to my songs and you write me your comments, like my videos, and you share my videos. It makes my everyday. See you very soon.